I am live. Hello, everybody. So, I've been saying as soon as I get some free time, I am coming up here to do this live because it's important. All right, so I've been reading from the book of Isaiah, and my God, the revelation that I have been getting is insane. Not just from also from what I've been listening to, which aligns with this Bible, the book of Isaiah. All right, so I know I've been sometimes sending y'all to, well, whoever be listening, like, I'll tell y'all to listen to this person, listen to that person. The only person you need to be listening to right now is the Holy Ghost, okay? God, read in your Bible, which I'm about to read from the Bible. We about to read from this Bible and, you know, get some and ask God to give you understanding. Ask God to give you, you know, a deep understanding of his word. So, I'm going to read from Isaiah chapter 6. But before I get into this, all right, we see what's going on in the world because I want you to correlate the two. Like, put together the two. The world right now that we're living in, where we have Russia and China gearing up for war. They're about to go to war. The talk of the town is they about to come and, you know, completely destroy America. That has been a prophecy that I've heard from prophets say this. One prophet that I do trust. I know I told y'all about a lot of ministries and stuff. I just say, don't listen to nothing I said. Just go to God, okay? Because even people I used to listen to, I don't listen to no more. And now I'm questioning everybody because God said in the last days, even the very elect will be deceived. And I'm still a baby in Christ, okay? I'm still learning myself. But don't listen to, don't just go listening to people having itching ears to hear a word. You need to go to God for yourself because right now it's crunch time, okay? It's crunch time. So, like I said, the prophecy was that the Russians in Asia was coming to destroy America. Like, America is Babylon in the Bible, right? You can believe what you want to believe. Ask God to give you understanding and show you what's true, okay? That's the best thing I can tell you. Don't go listening to nobody. Don't even listen to me before going to God, okay? You pray, go to God and pray and ask God for understanding and read your Bible. Read your Bible. But, a prophecy that I heard from somebody I believe is a true prophet. I'm not speaking names no more because nowadays you just don't know. Because a prophet that I used to talk about, that I was in her ministry and I was, you know, deep up in there. You don't know what these people got going on behind the scenes, and you don't know if God really even called them to be prophets or prophetess. This is the hour of false prophets, so just, you can't even believe every prophecy you hear. But the prophecies that's in the Bible, that's what you believe, that's what you go with. And the prophecy that I heard about how America will be destroyed and America's Babylon is literally in the book of Isaiah. Well, it doesn't say it's America, but it says Babylon. And, you know, you just got to go to God and pray and ask God, like, you know, Lord, is America Babylon? Like, is America what you talking about in the Bible? Like, when you say this is going to happen with all the details of what Isaiah said is going to happen to Babylon. Now, this ain't to scare nobody. This is just for y'all to get it right. We got to get it right before it's too late. Okay, so I'm going to just read this because it's important. So I'm going to start with Isaiah chapter 6, verse 6. And it says, then the seraphim flew to me with a burning coal in his hand, which he had taken from the altar with tongs. He touched my mouth with it and said, listen carefully. This has touched your lips, your wickedness, your sin, your injustice, your wrongdoing is taken away and your sin atoned for and forgiven. Then I heard the voice of the Lord saying, who shall I send and who will go for us? Then I said, here I am, send me. And he said, go and tell this people, keep on listening and do not understand. Keep on looking, but do not comprehend. Make the heart of this people insensitive, their ears dull and their eyes dim, Otherwise, they might see with their eyes, hear with their ears, understand with their hearts, and return and be healed. Then I said, Lord, how long? He answered, until the cities are devastated and without inhabitants, and houses are without people, and the land is utterly desolate. The Lord has removed his people far away, and there are many deserted places in the midst of the land. And though a tenth of the people remain in the land, it will again be subject to destruction, consumed and burned, like a massive terebinth tree or like an oak, whose stump remains when it is chopped down. The holy seed, the elect remnant, is its stump, the substance of Israel. Okay, so, you know, you got to ask God for understanding. I'm not a teacher, so I'm not going to sit here and, you know, explain what this may mean, because I'm still learning and the Holy Ghost is still teaching me, okay? But you have to go and ask God for understanding of what this means in full. And God will, I'm telling you, God is so faithful. And when you have come to him with a humble heart and really wanting to know what's going on, what's going to happen, what lies ahead for your future, God will show you what's up. I'm telling you, because I've had many dreams of a lot of destruction coming to this land, like coming to the earth, period, and all kinds of crazy stuff happening. And I'm telling you, when you start reading a Bible, it makes sense. It started making so much more sense to me. So that's Isaiah chapter 6, verse 6. Now, I'm going to read chapter 12 and then 13. But I'm going to read 13 before I read 12, because some of y'all got short attention spans and y'all need to hear chapter 13, because this is the headbanger. And then chapter 12 is more of the good news. But I suggest you read through the whole Bible, or the whole book of Isaiah, starting from the very first chapter to the end. In your time pace, like, it don't gotta be overnight, it don't gotta be in one day. Take your time with it, you know. It's a lot to consume. So chapter 13, let me let y'all hear this, because this is where it gets real, okay? Because this is what's going to happen, this is what's coming to the earth, this is what's coming to America, okay? All right, this is a prophecy from Isaiah. All right, it says, chapter of the book of Isaiah, chapter 13, the mournful inspired oracle, a burden. And I'm reading from the Amplified version. I don't know if I was said that from the beginning. I'm reading from the Amplified version. The mournful inspired oracle, a burden to be carried concerning Babylon, which Isaiah, the son of Amos, saw in a prophetic vision. Lift up a signal banner on the bare mountain. Summon them, the Medes and Persians, with a loud voice. Wave the beckoning hand so that they may enter the doorways of the Babylonian nobles. Oh, man, my God. I just realized something. So this is chapter 2. So I heard a prophecy where it says that Russia is going to enter into America the back way. So they're going to be coming through Canada to come and take over, like completely destroy and take over America. And they're going to enter in through the back way, which is Canada coming into America to destroy America. Now, listen to this, because this is a prophecy I heard from one of the prophetess that I believe is a true prophet. And everything she say, it align with the Bible. You got to go back and refer it to the Bible and make sure it's, because like I said, this is a day of the false prophet. And I'm not talking about prophetess Tiffany Montgomery. Let's just be clear. I'm not talking about her, because I don't know. Let me make that very clear, because I know I used to talk about her a lot and tell y'all to go listen to this, watch this. I'm not speaking of her, but I'm not gonna, like I said, I'm not gonna tell y'all who to go listen to. Y'all need to ask God and go to God for yourself about that. But read your Bible, more importantly. But it says, like, so it says, lift up. So chapter 13, verse 2, it says, lift up a signal banner on the bare mountains, summon them, the Medes and Persians, with a loud voice. Wave the beckoning hand so that they may enter the doorways of the Babylonian nobles. I, the Lord, have commanded my consecrated ones. I have even called my great warriors, my proudly exulting ones, the Medes and the Persians, who triumph for my honor, to execute my anger. Pause. God is angry with America because of all the sin. So it's a lot that's about to go down here. Just like America go and start wars in other places, there's war coming to America. Okay, mark my words, you don't gotta believe it now. It's gonna be at your doorstep if you still here when it all start happening. But back to chapter 13. Now we at verse 4. So God is sending warriors to execute his anger. It says, chapter 13, verse 4, a sound of tumult on the mountains, like that of many people, a sound of the uproar of the kingdoms of nations gathered together. The Lord of hosts is mustering an army for battle. They are coming from a distant country, from the end of heaven, the farthest horizon, the Lord and the weapons of his indignation to destroy the whole land. Well, for the day of the Lord is at hand. It will come as destruction from the Almighty, all-sufficient one, invincible God. Therefore, all hands will fall limp, and every man's heart will melt. They of Babylon will be shocked and terrified. Pains and anguish will grip them. They will be in pain like a woman in childbirth, which is painful. They will stare aghast and horrified at one another, their faces aflame from the effects of the unprecedented warfare. Listen carefully. The day of the Lord is coming, cruel with wrath and raging anger, to make the land a horror of devastation. And he shall exterminate its sinners from it. For the stars of heaven and their constellations will not flash with their light. The sun will be dark when it rises, and the moon will not shed its light. In this way, I will punish the world for its evil, and the wicked for their wickedness, their sin, their injustice, their wrongdoing. I will also put an end to the arrogance of the proud, and will abase the arrogance of the tyrant. I will make mortal man more rare than fine gold, and mankind scarcer than the pure gold of Ophir. Therefore, I will make the heavens tremble, and the earth will be shaken from its place. At the wrath of the Lord of hosts, and that in the day of his burning anger, and like the hunted gazelle, or like sheep that no man gathers, each foreign resident will turn and go back to his own people, and each one flee to his own land. Anyone who is found will be pierced through, and anyone who is captured will fall by the sword. Their children also will be smashed to pieces before their eyes. Their houses will be looted and their wives ravished. That means their wives will be raped. This means a lot of stuff, y'all. This is like, so when this war comes, people are gonna be, their kids, the sword going through, people gonna be killed, shot down, you know, stabbed down, like all the killing will be horrific. It's gonna be crazy. He was saying in 14 that in verse 14 how people are gonna, that people who came here, they're thinking that this is the American dream, they're gonna go back to their homeland. Like I said, I'm leaving America too. I'm out of here. As soon as I gather enough to go buy me some land somewhere, I'm gone. But people gonna go back to their homeland because they gonna see what's going on. But in the time when it's before it's too late, because it's gonna be a time when it's too late to leave. But yeah, people they're gonna be running through your homes, taking people, killing your children without remorse. This is what the Bible is saying. This is a prophecy from the Bible. So I've heard this outside of the Bible from a prophetess, and this is exactly what it's saying in the Bible. Listen carefully. I will put the Medes in motion. This is verse 17, chapter 13, verse 17. Listen carefully. I will put the Medes in motion against them, who have no regard for silver and do not delight in gold and therefore cannot be bribed. So that means these men, these warriors, they come in, they killing people without bribes. Like, you can't be like, oh, I got $1 million in the bank I can give you. No, they ain't taking no bribes. They come in to get the job done. Verse 18, their bows will cut down the young men of Babylon. They will take no pity on the fruit of the womb. Their eyes will not look with compassion on the children. And Babylon, the glory of kingdoms, the beauty of the Chaldeans' pride, will be like Sodom and Gomorrah when God overthrew them. Babylon will never be inhabited or lived in from generation to generation, nor will the Arab pitch his tent there, nor will the shepherds let their sheep lie down there, but desert creatures will lie down there, and their houses will be full of owls or ostriches also will live there, and wild goats will dance there. Hyenas will howl in their castles and jackals in their luxurious palaces. Babylon's time has nearly come and her days will not be prolonged. So God telling us that this is not going to be long before this happened. Now, this is, of course, the Bible prophecy from years ago, but everything has to happen at a time, and I believe the time is coming. I believe the time is coming soon, and I wish it wasn't true. I wish it wasn't going to happen, but I can't deny what this Bible say. And then, you hear the prophecies from God's true prophets, because there are still true prophets in the land, but it's not many, so you can't just go believe in everything everybody say. And it's going to happen soon. It's going to happen. We don't know when, but the point is to be prepared. Get yourself right with God so you don't have to be, so you could be his remnant that he is going to protect. And he's going to make a way to safety from his wrath. Okay? Now, chapter 12 is, of course, before chapter 13, but this is, more of good news. And on that day, you will say, I will give thanks to you, O Lord. For though you were angry with me, your anger has turned away, and you comfort me. Behold, God, my salvation, I will trust and not be afraid. For the Lord God is my strength and song. Yes, he has become my salvation. Therefore, with joy, you will draw water from the springs of salvation. And in that day, you will say, give thanks to the Lord. Call on his name in prayer. Make his deeds known among the people of the earth. Proclaim to them that his name is exalted. Sing praises to the Lord, for he has done excellent and glorious things. Let this be known throughout the earth. Rejoice and shout for joy, O inhabitant of Zion, for great in your midst is the Holy One of Israel. So that is like good news. It's like a comforting, like when you are hiding in the shadows of the Almighty, when you are dwelling in a secret place of the Lord. You know, God said 1,000, Psalms 91, he said 1,000 may fall at my side, at your side, 10,000 at your right hand, but it will not come near you. Only with your eyes will you see the reward of the wicked. Hold on tight to that, my fellow brothers and sisters who love God, because and who is obedient to God, and who is giving it their best to obey his commands. Because let me tell you, we ain't gonna be perfect. We gonna mess up every day. You know, we were born in sin, so we not perfect. The whole point is to come to God, tell him that you are sorry, ask him to forgive you and repent. That means turn away from the lifestyle that you was living that doesn't glorify God. Like, that's it. You gotta make a decision. You have to make a decision. Who are you going to live for? It's not no in between. It's either God or it's the devil. God or the devil. Like, y'all gotta make a choice. And you know, it's day by day. It's a day at a time. It's a day at a time. But I definitely had to come, talk about this, because like with Russia and China, the word from the Lord, from his prophets, he said that they are coming to destroy America. America is Babylon. America is going under, okay? We already know that if you live in California, you need to get up out of there. The San Andreas, like, it has already started cracking. I have put a video out that it is going to fall off. This is, people have been saying that, they've been knowing this for years. How long do you think something is going to be said, but it just doesn't happen? If you believe the word, if you believe that, if the word is true, like, yeah, they said, oh, they've been saying this. It's been, that's been said for centuries. Yeah, it's been said for centuries, but as eventually it got to happen. Eventually it got to happen. Man, it's starting to rain. Big drops, too. So it's time for me to head out. But I definitely want to come share this word. I love y'all. This is why I am a servant of God, doing even a work of an evangelist. Like, I'm just spreading the gospel, spreading the word, begging y'all to repent before it's too late. I am begging y'all. Like, I mean, I don't beg nobody for nothing. I am begging y'all to repent and get y'all life right before it's too late. To open your eyes, ask God to show you what is true and what is not. Ask God for wisdom, knowledge, and understanding. And that's, you know, the best that I could do is truly just beg y'all to just go to the Lord and repent and get your life right. Get your soul right. All right, I love y'all. I gotta go. It's chilly.